This video may contain violence, sexual themes, and a lot of swearing. Viewer discretion is advised.
Look what has become of you, a rat in the desert.
Look what I have risen above.
I have come to kill you, but perhaps it's worse to leave you here, festering in your squalor.
If you define yourself by your power to take life, a desire to dominate, to possess, then you have nothing.
And what do you have? Why come to this place? Not simply to hide. Oh, you have a purpose here. Perhaps you are protecting something? No. Protecting someone.
That's a thing.
Wait, what's your name?
Boblin the Goblin. Well, the Goblin isn't my last name, but I am a Goblin, so Boblin and I am a Goblin.
Yay!
It's a pleasure to meet you, oh.
I can show you the world.
You have $2.03.
I can show you my driveway.
Master?
Go with Mommy, Saris. Daddy's got work to do.
Am I your child in this scenario?
Saris, our group relationship can best be summarized as tags on Pornhub. Now go.
Fine, Dad.
Rachel, come on, talk to me, please!
You, I can't even look at you right now.
What?
Nothing.
You just said everything was okay. What are they talking about?
Just get away from me!
It was a mistake. I made a mistake, okay?
A mistake? What were you trying to put it in? Her purse? Where did he put it? Ross, you had sex with another woman.
Oh, my God.
Oh, God, I knew something had to be wrong because my fingernails did not grow at all yesterday.
DM story time. Before we started our session, one of our players said, "Hey, I made a playlist for this other player because they inspired me to do this because they're playing a tiefling bard who plays the saxophone and Careless Whispers is their signature song. I had to make this for the group." So I said, "Hey, send me that playlist. I want to put that to good use." And that I did for that one session. When they got into combat and the bard started playing on his saxophone, I changed the playlist from the battle combat music to the saxophone playlist, and of course, Mr. Saxo Beat was the first song on that list. I love it so much when players do nice things for other players, whether they make fan art, make each other really cool stuff. It just warms my heart, and I always support that.
Recently, Wizards of the Coast announced that they're going to be making a couple changes regarding the books and moving forward in the D&D universe. First of all, is adding sensitivity warnings to older media such as the second edition Oriental Adventures, and changing depictions of the Vrsini people, aka the Romani people, in Curse of Strahd, and other medias like that. But what I think is most cool and really interesting is in an upcoming book, which is unannounced for November, we're going to be getting a completely race overhaul, basically. From what we've heard, we're going to be getting rid of the plus ones and plus twos to ASIs and stuff from race, essentially putting everybody on a level playing field no matter what. This is quite frankly something I've wanted for honestly forever, but now it's finally actually being put into the game. In addition to this, they're also removing the fact that orcs and drow are inherently evil. They have now elevated drow to official knife-eared bastard.
Damn elves.
But that's just miscellaneous stuff with Chris, and as our lord Davy Jappy always tells us, fuck the fang!
Hey, holy man.
Yes, what is it, my son?
I have created something for you.
Well, then by all means, show me. That just seems like a normal... Oh, you son of a...
Dad.
Yes,
Dad,
Louise, hi. Yes.
Did you know that it only takes 2 pounds of pressure to drive someone's nosebone into their brain?
That's... what?
2 pounds! That's it, Dad!
Why are you telling me this, Louise?
Revenge.
I am a warrior of Odin. When I die, I shall join the fields and fight till Ragnarok.
I'm going to Yalhalla.
Does a 3 hit? It's a 36 to hit.
Holy crap. I was just hiking through the woods here, and I just realized I have a new D&D show premiering this week on my fucking Twitch channel. The Insight Check Show is a creator interview show where I take some of your favorite creators, we interview them, get to know about them, and then we play a one-on-one game of D&D together. Now these guests are not only going to be people in the D&D community, but they are also going to be big-time creators on the TikTok platform that are either into comedy, improv, fantasy, or even play D&D and you might not even know it. Now you might be wondering, Dice Cream, who's going to be your first guest? Who could it be? Wanna know? Here you go.
It is time for a dramatic reading from my DMs.
So how close are Tabaxi to actual cats? Like, do you need to flea treat them? I just had to flea treat my cat and he hated me for 3 days. Does the same thing happen to the party? Like, do they just have to pin the Tabaxi down, put the stuff on the back of his neck, and then he's just, like, standoffish with the party for 3 days? When you have him in a carriage, does he just sit in the corner going... like, all freaked out that he's moving without his legs moving? During bath time, do we have to, like, drag him down to the river and try to give him a bath, or do we all have to sit around the campfire and awkwardly watch him lick his butthole? Like, when you finally get to the big bad evil guy's lair and the big bad evil guy's trying to monologue, is he just over in the corner knocking shit off his desk?
And this is why I became the most evil person in the... What are you doing?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Stop that, I'm trying to monologue!
You say something? This is how I play my Tabaxis.
Hey there, I'm Greg, and I'm designing my own board game, but I've given myself 90 days to launch it on Kickstarter. Let's go!
Yesterday, I mentioned combat mechanics, and I want to show you what I'm currently doing. So whenever you turn over a battle card, you have who the opponent is, how many hit points they have, so how many times you have to win in battle, what weapon they're using, so you know if you have advantage or even disadvantage in some cases, and then what level they are. If they're level 2, that means I have to roll a 3 or higher. If they're level 3, 4, higher, 5, etc. So in this case, I'd roll my dice. It's a 3, so that means I would hit him and that would win. But if I had rolled a 1, that means he would have hit me and I would mark a hit point on my sheet. It works really well whenever you're doing combat and it's just 1 versus 1, but where it becomes complicated and doesn't really work as well is whenever it's multiple people fighting against multiple people, which is what I want to be having in the higher levels of the game. Some of them want to fuck.
Do it.
Right, so much to learn and see.
Don't be mimic, don't be a mimic. Don't be mimic, don't be a mimic, 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 mimic. Don't be a mimic, don't be a mimic. Don't be a mimic, don't be a mimic. Don't be a mimic, don't be a mimic.
To muse and blabber about a treasure map
in front of this particular crew demonstrates a level of ineptitude that borders on the imbecilic. And I mean that in a very caring way.
Imbecilic, did you say? Foolishness, I've got.
May I see the map, please?
Here.
Fascinating. Mr. Hawkins, in the future you will address me as Captain or Ma'am. Is that clear? Mr. Hawkins.
Yes, ma'am.
That'll do. Gentlemen, this must be kept under lock and key when not in use. And Doctor, again, with the greatest possible respect, zip your howling screamer.
Alright, so for this next round, you're going to be paired up with another team, and you're all going to be going up against the other two teams in combat. Now, you don't know which team you're going to be paired up with, but before that happens, you're each going to spin the wheel at the link that I gave you, and it's going to give you a buff or a debuff that you can apply toward any character.
I have a question.
Yes, Kiala. So I noticed there's like 100 different buffs and debuffs on this thing, and then there's one wedge that just says, you win on it? What does that mean?
Well, no, that's just a joke that I put in. You're not gonna land on that, don't worry about that.
Hi, yeah, one more question. Not really a question. I landed on it.
What?
Alright, so your character is dead.
Oh, one, two, three. So everybody's got a role initiative. Your action economy's vital, cause this shit is a rock, a beholder. But here in the white, it's damn clear to see we're in a fight. You see it right. The white hit it with a life drain, brought the max hit points down 7-4. Your tabaxi, it's a demon coming in from the walls. A banshee screaming from the end of the halls. The ranger's gonna give his pet bear a call, though it really doesn't tip the scales for them at all. I got him 10-6 at the start of the brawl. They're sticking with it, I'll admit it, they got balls. One's down, don't even stun him. Three's down, why aren't they running? I had so much more planned today. I swear I didn't mean to TPK him.
TikTok.
Die. Bob the Necromancer here. You know why nobody trusts a low dexterity wizard? Because he can trip at any moment.
You do know I can hear you, right? Why don't you go back to graveyard humor?
Yeah, graveyard humor. Cause you won't dig it.
We're men, manly men, we're men in tights.
Yes!
We roam around the forest looking for fights. We're men, we're men in tights. We rob from the rich and give to the poor, that's right. We may look like pansies. Don't get us wrong, or else we'll put out your lights. We're men in tights,
tights,
tights. Always on guard, defending the people's rights. When you're in the fix, just call for the men in tights. We're bunch.
And so, when someone says to you, "Hey, yo, fuck you! You don't know what you're talking about," you can just say, "No, fuck you." You don't know what you're talking about. And the beauty will be that neither of you know what you're talking about.
You know I'm your type, right?
Girl, don't do it. It's not worth it. I'm not gonna do it, girl.
I know him. That can't be. That's that little guy who spoke to me all those years ago. What was it? 85? That poor man.
Ladies, gentlemen, dungeon masters. As you may know, I am currently working on creating my very own monster manual, the Monstrous Opus. And I have just recently created a stat block for one of the 7 deadly sins. No, I do not mean the anime. Even though the anime does rock. But I digress. I have just started the deadly sin of pride. And I think I have just made a challenge rating 31 creature. But my D&D circle is sort of small, which makes testing high CR creatures a little difficult. So, if you think you and your friends are up to it, let me know, and I will send you a stat block for you to playtest. Keep rolling, my dudes.
So we're playing Magic,
and this is my commander, and he's my favorite commander, because essentially I get the top four cards on his deck, and I can steal one every time and just play it as it was any color, and this is my black deck. Well, I've used him twice, and every time I'm like, man, I'm just pulling straight up mana. That's because his commander just uses mana to create creatures, elemental creatures. So this is a commander deck, so it's 100 cards, so he has one creature and 99 mana, and he didn't fucking tell me. What do you have to say for yourself?
I texted the boys and said, hey, I'm about to play Amy with this deck and see how it goes.
You're an asshole.
These are things that annoy me because it's 2016. Let's fix this stuff already. These are not the big things. They're little bitty things that should be able to... The first one, why is printer ink so damn expensive? It is the most expensive liquid on the planet. Standard black ink is 70 cents per milliliter. You know what that is in dollars per gallon? $16,218 per gallon. Oh my God. Do not paint your house in magenta. It'd be very expensive. Let's compare this to other liquids. Human blood is 38 cents per milliliter. The essence of human life is cheaper than printer ink. That is so wrong. Look, penicillin's cheaper, vodka, Red Bull. But crude oil is a tenth of a cent per milliliter. They gotta drill a mile down and it's cheaper than printer ink. Where the hell are they getting printer ink? The core of the earth?
Wow, I usually don't do videos from my car like a jerk off, but all of this stuff about banning TikTok in America is just straight bullshit. Because first of all, yeah, TikTok is owned by a Chinese company and they do have access to some of your data and the Chinese government has access to some of your data. Okay, that's true and that needs to stop. But the servers for the American version of TikTok aren't even in China. They're in America and they're in Singapore. TikTok has an American CEO. The version of TikTok that you see in America, you can't even see that version in China. This is an American-controlled company that just so happens to be owned by a Chinese conglomerate. And that's the reason why it's being targeted by neocons in America because of their anti-Chinese stance. This is political bullshit. This has nothing to do with protecting your data. Now, yeah, the data stuff needs to be considered. People with the State Department and with the military and with the federal government probably don't need a TikTok. But all this stuff about banning it in America, it's just political bullshit because this is a far less toxic platform than Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram will ever be. And another thing. Really think about who creates the content you see on TikTok. Most of the popular content on this platform is user-generated content, okay? Unlike other social media sites, you know what I'm saying? You don't see CNN and Fox News and all these mainstream media corporations putting stuff out on TikTok all day long. They're too busy using Facebook and Twitter to divide us. They don't use TikTok like that. TikTok has content that is mostly created by the individual. Now, really think about that. Really think about why a government that wants to control what you see, control what you think, and control how you feel, really think about why they would want to shut a platform like TikTok down that doesn't have that same type of mainstream media control over it. Really think about that. I'll give you a second. And this is the last thing I have to say about this stupid ass TikTok ban. I don't think it's right for the Chinese government to have unrestricted access to the personal sensitive data of American citizens. Okay, that's wrong. That needs to stop. And hopefully TikTok and its parent company can change its policies and come to agreement with American authorities on that issue. However, what I will say is TikTok has banned a lot of political messaging on this platform. They have banned Holocaust deniers and people spreading baseless conspiracy theories and propaganda pages. TikTok is not trying to influence the 2020 election. TikTok is doing what Mark Zuckerberg refuses to do. And that's they are not allowing cowards to take control of this platform who simply just want to use it to spread chaos. And I hope it's not banned and we all have to go back to Facebook and Twitter where it's just a bunch of boomers arguing about Pizzagate and whether or not George Soros killed their dog. I really like this platform. All the underage twerking needs to stop, but this is a really great platform and I hope it doesn't get banned.